In this short video on AC simulation, I'll cover the controller setup, sources used for AC analysis, budget analysis, frequency conversion, and other miscellaneous information. For the basics of AC simulation, I'm going into the examples directory tutorial folder, and you can see it right here, examples tutorial. There are a lot of good examples in there with different setups for different types of circuits and different measurements. We're going to use the Amplifier 2 example project, and in the networks directory where all the designs are kept, you can see .dsn, I'm choosing the Amplifier 2 AC. And it's very simple. It has two behavioral models. One is an early version amplifier and the other Amplifier 2, just for comparison. Here you see the simulation palette with the simulation controller always in the left corner, and it's inserted here. It's set to 1 gigahertz with the node or wire labels set by name, amplifier and amplifier 2, and that way both of the voltages can be compared at the output. Let's open up the controller and look at the tabs. Notice the first tab is frequency. Unlike DC analysis, which has a sweep tab, there is an assumption that the frequency in AC analysis is either a single point, linear, or log. So by default, it's assumed you might sweep the frequency. But we're using a single point, and if we look at the next tab for noise, notice you can calculate noise. You can add the noise at different nodes, and this means for this one, we see amplifier and amplifier 2. Those are the two nodes that are named, as you can see here, and that would give you the noise at those nodes, and that's what the noise settings are here when you add or cut or paste. The noise contributors here, the mode is turned off, but you can sort them by name or value and so on, and that's so that whatever contributions there are in the data set organized this way. Dynamic range to display simply means that you can set a threshold. For example, if you only want the noise above minus 10 dB, you simply type that value in. Otherwise, you get everything. Include port noise means the noise that's contributed for each port. And that would be, in this case, ports such as these terminations, which in ADS are considered ports. If you had a 50 ohm resistor here, that would not be considered a port. Next, for the parameters tab, frequency conversion. This only works with the built-in ADS system mixers, and it takes into account there's up or down conversion, and you can have an equation that you write in schematic that allows for V in and V out, and it doesn't matter whether it's up or down conversion. But if you have your own mixer that you build with devices and biasing and an LO and so on, then this won't work. So strictly for our built-in mixers, budget is for any circuit. By using this, turning it on, you will get the current and voltage at every connecting pin for all of your components or all of your system blocks. So budget can be used for any of those. There are budget equations that can be inserted into schematic, and I'll show you those in a moment. Levels for all our simulator controllers is the amount of information written to the status window during simulation. And again, brief operating point for all of our simulation controllers is the same. This gives you DC values. This would be around your devices or the details, all the transconductance and so on. And if you go to the command simulate detailed device operating point or brief device operating point, then you can see those after the simulation right on the schematic. Otherwise, you'd have to go to the data set. And then here in the output tab, like all of the simulation controllers, you can select the node voltages, measurement equations, or branch currents that you want in the data set. Now keep in mind, if you just leave this in the default condition, you'll get everything that's on the page that is on your schematic design. But if you go to the add or remove, then you get the selections here which show you what's on the schematic, and then you can add or remove them as you want. So let's go ahead and cancel this. That covers the output tab, and again, it's similar for all the simulation controllers. And finally, display again is for any of the settings that you want displayed on screen so that they're right next to your AC controller. Now we've covered most all of the settings here. I'm going to close the dialog and quickly talk about sources. For AC, you have typically voltage and current sources. However, if you scroll all the way down, you'll see another source that's available, and that's the one I have here at the very bottom, P_AC. And here's the dialog. As you can see, it's a power source. Let's cancel it, and let me show you that the individual source here has the word num, N-U-M equal 1, and that means this can be used as a port. Therefore, if we go into the palette for AC simulation, that's where we got the controller here, and notice that it also has the standard options, parameter sweep and sweep plan, that are the same in every simulation palette, so they can be used from any palette. If you notice, it also has a set of budget equations for AC analysis. Budget gain I've already inserted, and looking closely at it, you can see it is specifying port 1 as one of the arguments, and that's when you would use that AC power port. It also has other arguments for this particular bud_gain function, and you can read the help on that. All of the ADS built-in equations use built-in functions. Now, that covers most of the basics for AC simulation, including budget gain and some of the sources. Notice that the regular VAC source typically is set with a polar function, but you can change these functions, and a lot of these details are covered in our ADS classes. Just for example, what you see is the word freak here. Freak equals freak, so when you have a source here, you don't have to set the frequency here, you can simply set it here, and the controller then will take ownership, and that's the way that works. And finally, here in the data display for this example, we see that both of these amplifiers have the same complex voltage. And that covers all of the basics for AC analysis.